Hi, Stephen. My name is Virginia, and today is my first day. I was hoping that you could tell me just a little bit about Lean and how Xylem implements that.
Hey, Virginia. Well, basically, Lean is a methodology of running a business and a culture in a business place that tries to eliminate certain types of waste. Examples of waste are motion, having excess inventory, overproducing something, overprocessing something, and you know, another one is also too that some people don't think about is unused employee genius. So if you get people out here and they don't feel like they can share what they know, then you're kind of wasting that. You'll be able to get them involved in everything. So making sure everybody's areas are efficient and clean and everything's easy to access. You're not running for stuff. You're not, okay, I need this, and you're going all the way over to the shop. Well, Lean empowers you to say, I'm done with running all the way over there. I'm just going to put it over here and eliminate, you know, what, 30 miles a year of walking, whatever it happens to be. So we quantify a lot of our Lean improvements. So.
That's great. Can you tell me a little bit about how you've implemented Lean in your personal life?
Personal life. My girlfriend's saying it. My three kids are saying it. We'll be somewhere and one of my kids will say something, wow, Dad, that doesn't seem very lean. And we're like, well, why not? You know, and so I start prodding them into a little bit, why isn't it lean? Well, because they did this and this. So
that's great.
Yeah, absolutely.
A very engaging conversation and a training session. I like that. I've got a three-year-old, so I'm going to see if I can incorporate that at home.
Absolutely, and it can really help with your home life, too, because you've got so many things going on at home that, you know, if you can eliminate 30 miles of walking by getting rid of a few steps every morning or something, you know, all of those separate things all cumulatively really add up and start making life easier.
That's exciting.
Yeah, absolutely. It's really exciting when you start taking it home. That's one of the parts of the whole Lean process too, is when you see your employees starting to take it home, you know that it's working.
Tell me a little bit about how you think respect plays into the Lean culture.
Respect. If you've got a workplace that you've got people who don't show respect for each other or their environment and surroundings, it comes out in attitudes and how smoothly everything flows, how well people work together. If you've got two people who just have an attitude, you know, and they haven't checked it at the door in the morning, and they're working near each other and something pops up and rears its ugly head, they're going to probably have a hard time working through it without having some sort of, you know, friction going on there.
Sure.
So it really makes for a smoother workplace and a workplace that you're really happy to come to in the morning. In fact, I just told Greg this morning, asked me how my weekend was, and I was like, yeah, it's all right, but had work this morning to look forward to coming to, and so.
More chaos at home and less chaos at work. I like it.
Right, yeah, absolutely. And if you get enough, if you really get your mindset into it enough, then that less chaotic mind state starts spilling over into your home and it just starts encompassing how you think.
I like it. The idea of a symbiotic lifestyle, I guess, and incorporating that Lean culture into both work and home and having...
You don't have a dichotomy.
The stress-free.
Exactly. Stress-free, maybe not, but...
Stress-reduced?
Yeah, absolutely stress-reduced. And once you get to a point where it becomes just a mindset, it doesn't become, I think like this at work, and I think like this at home, and I think like this when I'm out playing, doing whatever, it all just becomes how your mindset is.
One flow,
and you start seeing it everywhere.
So what would you say is one big project that you're really looking into as your next big step to try to make more lean with your particular workspace?
My particular workspace is the shipping and receiving department mainly. I go into other areas also, but the main thing over here in shipping and receiving is I know where everything's at, but I think it should be really easy for everybody else to find where it's at. I'm not always here, or somebody just needs to go look at a product or something. And so I've been thinking about organization methods back here of what would make it easy for a new person to come back and find something. You know, should we have all the easels in one spot, or should we have it all by alphabetical, you know, SWB03-04-06 and all the S's in a row, so on and so forth. So it's just something I'm kind of tossing around for new people to become more efficient when they're in this area also.
That's great. If you could ask for one big improvement company-wide, what would that be?
Double everybody's pay. Okay, maybe not. I really don't have a whole lot. I mean, it's just got a coffee machine. That's great. I mean, just little things like that just kind of keep the employees happy and going. And, you know, it's a great place to work. I don't have a whole lot of complaints.
Great. So. Well, thank you for your time, Steven.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure.
Yeah, you too.